Good morning, class. How are you all? I hope you all are well and staying your home. And also, I hope you all are doing your study well. If not, be serious about your study, right? Okay. So, in the previous class, what we have learned? We all have learned about the soil erosion and its causes, right? So what is soil erosion? We'll take a quick revision, right? So soil erosion is what? The removal of the fertile soil, topmost layer of the soil from the land by the force of wind, water, running water, by the human activities, right? So that is what? That is called the soil erosion, right? And also we have learned about the many causes of soil erosion. So the causes are wind, then running water, right? And human activities. In human activities, what are the causes? Deforestation, overgrazing, right? And plowing the hill, means making the way on the hills or doing farming on the hilly area, right? So that all are the causes of soil erosion, right? Okay. So what we are going to learn today? We are going to learn today the conservation of soil. As you know, the soil erosion is very harmful for us, right? The topmost layer, the fertile soil, that is very important for us, because if the no soil on the earth, so what would be happen? We cannot get the food, right? We cannot think about the life, right? So that is very important for us, the soil, right? So we are going to learn about the how we can conserve the soil, right? We have to if the soil erosion would be happen, how, what we can do? We can conserve the soil, we can prevent the soil. So how we can prevent the soil, and why we should be conserve the soil, that is we are going to learn today. Let us come do the activity, right? How we can conserve the soil, right?
See here, there is a soil, and see, when I am blowing air, what is happening? From this bottle, the soil is blowing, means the force of wind is removing the soil, right? So that is what happening, that is a soil erosion, right? And see here, from this bottle where I have planted the tree, I have planted the some plants, what is happening here? No soil is removing from the plant, means no soil is eroded from this, right? And from this, what is happening? The soil is it removing from one place to another due to force of wind, right? See here, the next activity, I am throwing the water in this. See you. What happened? See there, some soil is eroded from this bottle, and see the water that is I have collected in the glass, and see in this, I am throwing the same amount of water in this bottle. I'm throwing the same amount of water in the see, I have sown the this activity. What you have observed? See here, I have thrown same amount of water in both bottles, in both soil. What happened? See here. See this glass of water. How it is? See, some soil is settled at the bottom. Settled down at the bottom. You can see it, right? And see in the next glass, that was here, in which tray I have planted the plants. Some plants. See, there is no soil settled down at the bottom of the glass. There is only water. Right, there is only water. So think, what did you observe from this activity? What did you observe? So what did you observe by this activity? We have observed, we have learned by this activity that plant, how the plant can conserve the soil, how the plants is really important for us, how they are they are very important for the soil, how they can conserve the soil, right? As you know, the soil is very important and very important natural resource, right? So it because it takes millions of the years to form, the soil takes millions of the years to form. So that what we should do, we should conserve from its erosion, right? So by this activity we have learned that the plants are very important to conserve the soil. By the plant we can conserve the soil. How they can conserve? Because the plant can bind the soil together, right? The plant can bind the soil together and its roots penetrate in the soil. So the soil cannot be eroded, right? So there is some ways, by following these ways we can conserve the soil, right? So what is first way? I am writing here. Take your pencil and notebook, note down the points, right? The first is what? A forestation. A forest station, right? So a forest station, what is a forest station? So growing the plant in large scale, growing trees and plants in large scale, that is called a forest station, right? And the people for their they are cutting down the trees for their own requirement, for their needs. They are cutting down the trees and forests. What they should do? They should be planted the trees on the place of the cut the tree. They should be planted the trees on the place of cut trees. So what would be happen by this? The it would be sufficient plant will be available, right? For the on the place of where the plants are cutting, the forest are cutting, and if the plant would be sufficient on that place, then it can be conserve the soil erosion. Because if the plants would be there, so no soil would be eroded from that place by the rain, by the wind, and by the any type of weather, right? So that is the way, by the afforestation and by reforestation we can conserve the soil erosion, right? Reforestation kya hai? The reforestation, that is when we are cutting the when we are cutting the trees for our requirements, right, for our needs, and we are planting the trees on the same place where we are cutting the trees, that is reforestation, right?
Then next one is a what? The next point is going shopping in farmland. In farmland, growing plants in farmland. What is this? If the land is not being used for farming, right, for growing crop, so what we should do? We should grow some type of grasses and trees on that land, right? We should be grow some type of grasses and we should grow the some type of trees on that place, that place where the land is not being used for growing crop, right? What would be happen by this? It can be when the trees would be grow on that place, it would be bind together the particle of the soil and it can be conserve the soil erosion. And also the farmers, what they should do, if they should grow the seasonal fruits, pulses and vegetables, if the crop, until the crops grow, right? So क्या होगा इससे, whenever the rain come with due to running water, wind या any other reason, what would be happen? The soil cannot be erode. And what be what other thing we should do? We should also grow the plants, grow the trees on the edges of the river or the places wherever the running water near the the soil erosion, and also the growing trees on the edges of the farmland, right? On the edges of the farmland, growing trees and bushes, what would be happen? It also can be conserve the soil erosion. It can be reduce the force of wind, and by reducing the force of wind, it also can be conserve the soil erosion. So that is the second way. Then the next one is. Next one is providing over grazing. Over grazing, right? So, as I told you in previous class, the over grazing is also a cause of soil erosion. So, what we should do? We should take care about that. The all the type of many cow and sheep, the animals that are herbivore, the animal that are herbivore, they should not be allowed to overgraze. They should not be allowed to graze again and again on the same place for a long time, right? Overgrazing is what? If the animals are grazing on the same area, on the same place for a long time, that is overgrazing. So we should not be allowed to do that for the animals. We should take care about that. And why? Because if they are grazing, the animal are grazing on the same place for a long time, what would be happen? The soil loses up, and it is cause of, it would be cause of soil erosion, right? So also we should take care about that, the this one, right? The next one is a construction of embankments. What is construction of embankments? As you know, the running water, due to running water, the large amount of soil, top soil, fertile soil, it washes away during the floods. It washes away during the floods. So what we should do? If we are making the strong if we are making the embankment, by the strong embankment, we can conserve the soil. What would be happen? By putting the stones, strong embankments on the both side of river, what would be happen? during the flood, what would be happen? If the flood did not come by the running water, by the river water or by the stream, it would be prevent by the flooding, from the flooding, and by the adjoining the fields and check the soil erosion. So we can prevent by the flooding in this area. So the soil erosion would not be happening. The running water cannot be washed away the fertile soil, right? So we should make the strong embankments at the both side of river or stream, right? So that is the way we can conserve the soil, right? The next topic is the next point is strip farming. Farming, or we can say terrace farming. What is terrace farming? On hill slopes, that fast running water is very rapid. That is a rapid, the fast running water flows on the hill area, on the mountains, right? So it carries away the large amount of fertile soil with it. It washes away the large amount of fertile soil with it, right? So the terrace farming is done on the hill area. That is the way we can conserve the soil, right? We can reduce the soil erosion. Strip farming, by the strip farming, what are the importance of the strip farming? How it is helpful to conserve the soil, right? This reduces the flows of water as it flows from the hills. Step by step, what is happening? The step by step, when water flows, its force will be less. When the water comes from one step, so the soil which is eroded from the flowing water on the hill, it deposited in the next step. Then again, what happened? Then all the soil that is eroded from the second step, then it deposited in the third step. So gradually, what would be happen at the last, at the bottom, what would be happen? The eroded soil would be less. Yeah, loss of eroded soil. Further, it would be less, right? So it would be deposited at the bottom of the soil. Bottom of the hill. So the soil erosion would not be happen. It would be happen very less. The top most layer of the fertile soil, it also would be collected. It would be deposited in the further. It is deposited in the next to next step on the hilly area. So it by the step farming, we can reduce the flowing water. We can reduce the speed of flowing water, and we can conserve the soil erosion, right? जैसे अगर आपके घर में आप थिंक अबाउट दैट देयर इज नो स्टेप ऑन एट योर होम, देन व्हाट वुड बी हैपन? क्या होगा? आप छत से कैसे कूद के आओगे? तो क्या होगा? आपको चोट लग जाएगी. बट आप क्या करते हो व्हेन यू आर कमिंग स्टेप बाय स्टेप एट योर होम? तो क्या होता है? तो एकदम इजिली यू कैन कम एट द इन द नेक्स्ट फ्लोर. यू कैन कम इजिली बाय यूजिंग द स्टेप. सो एज द सेम वे, the force of flowing water, when it comes from the sky, it comes from the high, so that the force would be very high. So step by step, what would be happen? The force would be less, and the soil would not be eroded, right? also we can conserve by the step farming on the hilly area, the soil erosion, right? So these all are the ways, these all are the points, by following these ways we can conserve the soil, right? So it's all about the conservation of soil. Okay, if you are having class, I think am I clear? If you are having any query, any question, you can ask me. Okay, so bye class, have a nice day.